This is your divine appointment. I'm back again with a little more exciting things to share about what the Lord has given me for you today. And I just want to share another dream I had just recently. And I just can't help but concentrate, because this is what the Lord has been giving me, is concentrating on some of the things that are hardest to do. And I want to share my dream first, and then I'm going to share some scriptures with you. And it was real simple. It was a real simple, small dream, but it was very right to the point. And I love when God does that. You can't think of these things. You just can't make them up. It's just, you know, so sweet and yet so awesome at the same time. And He loves you. He loves me. He wants us all to be prepared and ready. And as I shared, and I've been sharing, and as you've heard, you all know by now where we need to really be preparing our lives and our hearts, those of us that are the body of Christ. And I know that it's only going to be a small remnant that it's going to be really receiving these things. A lot are just not going to receive these things. They're going to go on and think they're okay, and they think they're arrived, and they think that, it's just the way it is. I mean, these kind of kids were in school with us when we were little. These same kids, we go to these reunions and we meet up with these same kids that are grown up, and they've still got this attitude. They still think they have to show somebody else up. I know you know what I'm talking about. They just don't want to learn, and God wants us to learn. You know, these people that we meet in our, I can't help it, it just popped in my head. I just started thinking about that. When you go to a reunion and you meet these people and you think, oh my gosh, they were really a mess when they were younger, and they're still a mess today. You think, when are they going to learn, you know? And then others have just like, wow, you've really changed. God has really done a miracle in your life, done amazing things. And sometimes they'll share their testimony, and sometimes they don't know the Lord at all. So all these things are an opportunity to share Jesus with others. But it's amazing how some people never want to learn. So I know I'm only going to be ministering to a small group of people here. And, I've had to learn these things the hard way, even in my own life. But let me share quickly this dream. I was bathing a puppy. And we've all had some experience like that with a kitten or maybe a puppy. And they're miserable and unhappy because they don't want to be in that water, although they're enjoying it many times. And if we're careful and if we're loving and kind while we're doing it and patient, we can clean them up. We can get them cleaned. And sometimes we just need to get... They're in a mess. They made a mess and they walked in it. They're just like little kids. They don't know. They're made a mess and they're just walking in it, and they don't even realize what a mess they've made. So you are cleaning them up. Okay, so here I am cleaning up this puppy, and all the way I'm cleaning him up, I kept saying, I've got to clean you, I've got to clean you. Don't move, don't move. The more you move and the more you fight, the harder it's going to be, the harder it's going to be. And sure enough, he gets open his eyes, and I've got to clean out the eyes and pouring, you know, cool water over his eyes and so on and so forth. And I'm making it all right, making it all happen. And he's trying to open his eyes again. I'm saying, no, no, don't do that again. Just keep your eyes closed. And so anyway, what I had to do is, you know, I went through this whole thing in my dream. And when I woke up, I asked the Lord what this meant. And you see, we don't like to be cleaned up. There's areas in our lives, all of us. I've got some things that I'm still dealing with in my life and praying about. We all do. All of us do. But you know what? It's got to be done. It's got to be done. And it's got to be done quickly. It's like getting a shot, or it's like getting the baby a bath or the puppy a bath, and they squirm and they don't want to have it. They don't want it, and they end up getting, you know, hurting themselves or getting the soap in their eyes, and it stings and it hurts. The sting and the hurt and the pain is going to be all gone once we take care of the situation. Because many times, you know, we just are stinging. This is like sitting in the back burner of our life, the situation, this person, the words maybe you spoke to them, the things that maybe you said, the things you might have done when you were just didn't know any better. You know, we need to, like in my last video, we're talking about cleaning up. We just, you know, this is something it's a continual battle. And you know, the longer we live in this world, the more junk we're going to get covered up with. It's like that snowball going down the hill that I talked about. It gets corroded, it gets covered in our lives, and we get more and more on us, and it gets dirtier and dirtier as it goes down the hill. And you know, that's how life is with us. And if we're cleaned up, it's so clean and beautiful. We feel so good when we're clean again. And if something you know has got to be cleaned up, sometimes you want to hide it. Sometimes you don't want it to be noticed. It's just like running around chasing after that little puppy. He made a mess all over in that dream, and he's walking. You know, if you've had experiences like that, I'm sure. Even a child with a dirty diaper, they run around, they don't want to change, you know, and then their diaper's, you know, dribbling all over the place. You know what? They don't want to be cleaned up. They just want to continue with what they're doing and having a good time. They want to cover all that stuff up. And the sin in our life is the same way. We just don't want to deal with it. It's too painful. Let's just forget about that. But the Lord is saying, no, it's going to be too painful. It's not worth it. Some of these sins in our life are not little, but they seem little to you. They seem little to you, but they're big in the eyes of God. Okay. And it says in 1 Corinthians, do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God? You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. So glorify God with your body. Glorify Him. Glorify Him in all your ways and all the things you say and do. Finally, brother, whatever things is true, whatever things is honorable, whatever things is just and pure, whatever things is lovely, whatever things are commendable, if there's any excellence, if there's anything worthy of praise, think on these things. Think of those things. Think of those things which you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, says the Lord. The things you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Do these things. Practice these things. And the God of peace will be with you. There'll be no peace. I'm going to close this up because I think I'm done with this. There'll be no peace until you're done with it. There's going to be no peace until you get it out. Cleanse it. Let God cleanse you. Let God cleanse you completely and get this stuff out. Okay? We're none of us perfect. We know. I know. I know. There's things right now I'm dealing with way back when. But you know what? There's no time anymore. We've got to cleanse our lives for the Lord. We're the temple of the Holy Spirit. We are His temple. Let's go on and say here, it says here in Psalms 39. I love the scripture. I say this often because I love it so much. Search me, O Lord, and know my heart. See if there be any wicked way in me. See if there'll be any wicked way in me. And lead me in thy ways everlasting. We need to continually ask the Lord to show us our ways that are not pleasing to Him, that are, some of it's wicked. Some of you are walking in wickedness. It's not easy to say this, you know, because it's not a way to influence friends and gain friends and influence them. You don't want to hear this, you just nub me out and just don't want to watch again. You know, I don't care. I just have to speak what the Lord is saying. You know why? Because we all need to learn these things. And I had to learn this early in my life to be cleansed at all times. Search me, O Lord. Search my heart. Let me read it out of the Living Bible. It's a little different in here. It's not as strong as the King James. I like the strong strength of King James because we can't, it's real. We've got to just get it out. But it says here, search me, O God, in the living, and know my heart, and test my thoughts. Point out anything you find that makes you sad. And then lead me along the paths of everlasting life. Everlasting life. It's in heaven. It's not worth missing everlasting life. It's a gentle way of putting it. The other way is, see if there be any wicked way in me. see if there be any wicked ways in me, and lead me in thy ways everlasting. Search my heart, O Lord. Search my heart, O Lord. This is a wonderful prayer to say to help you to cleanse. You know, like I just shared about my dream, you know, you squirm. We all do. It's not easy. Sometimes these things are very uncomfortable. Do it however you can do it. Do it however you can do it. God will help you. You know, search me and know my heart. See if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in thy ways. He will lead you in the way to do whatever needs to be done in a way that's going to be good. Okay? If there is somebody that it involves a person that's been cruel and bad, hurtful, I always say, if you've been raped, you don't want to go back to that rapist and be his buddy. You just can't do that. God has to deal with that person. You've got to leave that alone. Okay? But you do what you can do. Even if you can't connect with the friend for some reason because it's too horrifying, or there was some damage done that was so horrible in your life, and like I say, a rape or something like that, that's a whole different story. But anytime you can, and you pray and you give that to the Lord and say, Lord, I know I can't forgive them and I can't deal with this, but every day I ask you to work it out in my heart. I don't want to hold bitterness and hatred toward them. I just pity this person who did this to me, and I ask you to forgive them. But I can't, you know, if you know in your heart that you cannot be have a valid friendship, you just keep praying about it. God will lead you. God will lead you. I can't give you those answers. Only God can do that. But I will say this. The scriptures are beautiful. And he says, search my heart, O God, and know my heart. Test my thoughts and point out anything you find in me that makes you sad. Okay? Lead me along the paths of everlasting life. And God will take care of it. I love you today. I really, really love you, and I care about your heart, and I want us all to be pleasing to God, all of us. We walk through this world and this life. We want to be pleasing to the Lord. We all have little things we like to hide under the carpet. But you know something, there comes a time, and that's the time is now. We need to just get all this stuff from under the carpet and all the corners. And a friend of mine used to call them little bunnies, little dust bunnies. As soon as you put your room down the floor, the little dust balls would just run to another spot. It's easy to just overlook it and let it go. Don't let it go. The only one that really hurts in the end is you, okay? The little dream I had was just a little quick little snippet of a dream, but the Lord is saying, don't squirm and don't fight it. Take care of business, and you'll be clean and beautiful in my eyes. And be pleasing to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Shepherd of our soul. God bless you today. I want to remind you all, you can always look below for my information. I do counseling by phone, 1 hour of beautiful, anointed counseling. Not psychologist counseling, just a gift from God to listen and to give scriptures and to guide you in all your ways, as God has led me for years to counsel people from time to time, and over the years in different churches and different congregations and ministries I've been in, as well as my own, that I've been in counseling with people for years. If you have something you need to be counseled about and you need godly wisdom and help and encouragement and advice, I have 1 hour of counseling. I always forget to mention it, but it's always below. Those of you that have not received Christ, I want you to receive him in your life. No more time. It's no more time. God bless you all today. I love you. Thank you for my subscribers. Don't forget to thumbs me up, make your comments, and share with others some of the things that God has done in your life so you can bless others in those comments. I love you today. I just know that God is with you as you give your all to him and do all that he's calling you to do. Okay? He loves you today. It's been your divine appointment. I'll see you next time.